A few days ago, I injured my right hand wrist at gym. Afterwards, every time I used my mouse, it caused lot of pain because of steep wrist angle. That's when it hit me. Wouldn't it be great if you could convert any surface into trackpad? And I don't know why, but for some reason I thought of her. The movie Her. I will let you guys figure it out. This was an exciting thought, but I didn't know if I could do it. Still, I decided to give it a try. Before we start, I have a disclaimer. At the end of these videos, I couldn't convert any surface into a trackpad. But I learned a lot and added big tools to my arsenal. I hope this happens to you too. Let's get started. I set up a Raspberry Pi along with camera at height of about 45 cm. This gives us monitoring area of about 25 by 25 cm underneath that camera. Following that, we need a piece of code that decides if there is a hand in that area, and if so, where is it? Take a look at this link or one of my previous Raspberry Pi mini projects to get your headless Pi up and running. Piece of code that lets us decide if there is a hand in area of interest uses something called neural network. They fall under category of programming where you don't define rules to make any decision, but you show neural network enough data that it figures out rules on its own. In our case, instead of coding what hand looks like, we show neural network images captured from Raspberry Pi that contains hand and that does not contain hand. This phase is called training of neural network, and images used is called training dataset. I remote logged into my Raspberry Pi and captured bunch of images using this command. I captured about 80 images with hand and 80 images without hand. 160 images are not enough to properly train a neural network, but should be enough for proof of concept. Besides these 160 images, I captured 20 images more to test our neural network once it is trained. I wrote my neural network in Python deep learning library called Keras, and code was written on Jupyter notebook from Anaconda Navigator. First, I include all the libraries needed for this mini project, which includes PIL, Matplotlib, NumPy, OS, and Keras. In second cell, I define paths to dataset and print out sample count. Now we need to load all images into a NumPy array. Hence, I create a NumPy array of 157 × 100 × 100 × 3. 3 is for red, green, and blue color layers in image, and 100 × 100 is our resized image dimension. In 4th and 5th cell, we load images containing hand followed by images that does not contain hand in our NumPy array. In 6th cell, we divide each value by 255, hence limiting value range from 0 to 1. This is how our training set looks now. Next, we need to label each image. Hence, we create a one-dimensional NumPy array of 157 in length. First 82 entries are set to 1, and remaining 75 entries are set to 0. This conveys to neural network that first 82 entries are from one class and remaining 75 entries are from another. In cell number 9, we define our neural network. It contains 3 repetitions of convolution layer followed by max pool layers with 8, 12, and 16 convolution filters respectively. Following that, we have 2 dense neural nets. Image above 9 cell is pictorial representation of our neural network with output dimension and operations annotated. In cell number 10, we configure neural network optimizer to Adam and loss function to binary cross entropy. They play major role in how weights of neural network are updated. Finally, on running cell number 11, neural network starts training. Just look at loss function and make sure it is decreasing. Once trained, we need to prepare test dataset. We repeat procedure done on training dataset in 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th cell on the test set. We also prepare label for test set, but this time we run model on this dataset to get predictions and not to train. I got test accuracy of 88%. Take this with a pinch of salt, as dataset used to train this model is very small and inadequate to properly train this neural network. That's it for first part of mini project number 28. In next part, which I'll upload in a week or two, we will train another neural network that gives us coordinate of hand detected. I hope you liked this video. If so, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. I will see you soon with another video. Till then, train your network.